Good morning, cadets. Our subject for this morning is the fundamentals of infantry operations. This subject that we're going to take up this morning is a continuation of the introduction of the infantry battalions. We have taken up last time the introduction. So this is a continuation. We will be talking this morning the different formations from company, platoon, and squad. And of course, actions during danger areas. In actual combat, cadets, is different from this guide of references. Anyway, as I've said, I mentioned this subject that books, references are guide, but in the actual combat, meron nababago yan because hindi nyo ma-apply kung i-follow mo yung libro sa actual encounter during sa confrontation with the enemy. So anyway, ganun din, ganun pa man, we will study this, no? We will discuss this fundamental of infantry operations. We will be talking about the different formations and movement of the platoon and squads. Of course, I will going to share to you, to everybody that, of course, you know, basta nagkakandak ako ng lecture, meron akong isineshare, no, na experience ko sa actual combat. Because as I've said, I'm a veteran. Matagal ako sa battlefield. I mentioned to you before that you know, I have already a perpetual souvenir 3 times na wounded in action. Kaya itong isishare ko sa inyo, ito, mayroon tayong binabasa na libro, but then iko-correlate ko sa mga experience ko when I was assigned in Mindanao. Right, cadets, the scope of the subject that we're going to take up this morning is number one, mission. Number two, limitations and capabilities of squad and platoons. Number three, the different movement, formation, and techniques. And number four is the actions at danger areas. So those are the scope of the subject that we're going to discuss this morning. So to start, we will start with our mission. Ano yung mission of the infantry operation? The infantry platoon is the smallest deployable unit having elements that will confront the enemy face to face. It is organized and equipped to fight with swift and lethality. Swift, kailangan kuan ka agad. Yung tinatawag nating fast. Independent movement of squads shall always be part of the platoon or as part of an operation of a larger force. They benefit from the support of its parent unit. Ano yung parent unit nila? Doon sa company. And from armor, artillery, mortars, close air, and engineer assets. So, so the mission of the infantry platoon is to confront the enemy in order to defeat, capture, repel his assault, and weaken his fighting capability. Yan ang mga mission ng infantry operation. The success in battle hinges of the platoons and squads. Reaction during engagement, their ability to close with the enemy, and to appropriately act upon contact. The proper employment of suppressive fires and the ability to maneuver to vulnerable flanks determines the overall outcome of battle. Then, the capacity of the elements of the platoon to gain the support of the people and the community from which the enemy derives its financial, material, logistical, and operational support, could tip the balance of tactical power that could enhance the security of the platoon over its conduct of operations in a designated area of operations. These successful actions heavily rely on the ability of the platoon leader and the quality of soldiers in the platoon and squads. So, yan ang mga mission, no? As we go on, maiintindihan nyo yung i-discuss ko because meron ako mga example mamaya, yung mga different kinds of movement, how to engage the enemy. So, ito yung mission ng infantry operations. So, as I've said, as we go on, maiintindihan nyo later on as we go along. Next. Limitations and capabilities of squads and platoons. Oh, every kahit ang tao, meron tayong kanya-kanyang limitations and capabilities. Just like you cadets, meron din kayong mga limitation and capabilities. Just like sa military way of life, yung mga platoons and squad, may mga limitation and capabilities. We will going to talk this limitation and capabilities of squad and platoons. Capabilities. Ano yung capabilities ng yung capabilities and limitations of squad and platoon? The infantry platoon is capable of operating independently or together with other forces to perform the following. Independently, hindi dependent. Independently yan. Sila-sila lang. Letter A. Maneuver in all types of local weather and terrain. Kahit ano yung kwan, umuulan, bumabagyo. Yan ang capabilities. Kahit anong klaseng weather dyan. The best weather for a soldier, especially rangers, during rainy seasons, kung ano yung dark or anong klaseng weather, yan ang capable ang mga military, especially the army or the rangers. And terrain, kahit anong rugged yung terrain, up and down, muddy or anong klaseng terrain yan, are capable to conduct operations. Seize and hold any terrain. Ayan, nag-hold dyan ng sinatawag natin na yung platoon. In any terrain, kahit anong klaseng terrain, then say secure a designated area of operation for short and relatively long period. Isisecure nila yan. Kung halimbawa, short period ang to conduct the operation or long period. Depende yan. It depends upon the platoon leader or it depends upon the situation, especially in counter-insurgency operation. Dito sa atin, ano ba yung sinasabi na counter-insurgency operation? Look at what had happened sa Miag-Au, di ba? Yung mga counter-insurgency, yung mga NPA, last December 1, 17 NPA patay sa Sitio Burak, Barangay Alimujas, Magyaw, Iloilo. Yung mga NPA doon was surprised and suffered heavy casualties. So, kayang-kaya only, I think, a platoon only who conduct the raid in a certain area in Sitio Burak last December 1st. At ganun ang capable ng mga platoons natin. Yung 61st Infantry Battalion yata yun, o 3rd Infantry Brigade. Secure a designated operation short period, yung sinasabi ko, then after that, isisecure nila yung area very short para at least yung reinforcement hindi makapasok. Then, infiltrate into enemy controlled terrain or areas. So, meaning, the capabilities ng squad and platoons can infiltrate into enemy controlled terrain or areas. Yung mga controlled ng kalaban, yung mga terrain, yung mga rugged, kasi doon nagkakampo yung mga enemy doon sa pinakamahirap na lugar na hindi mararating ng akala na hindi mararating ng mga troops natin, yung mga friendly troops or the operating units or areas. Doon sila nagkakamp. Letter A, conduct operations in semi or urban areas. Alam mo, yung urban na tinatawag, ha? Yung may mga village, yung urban, I would like to mention about the urban areas that the military conduct operation. Sa Marawi, medyo nahirapan ang mga rangers pumasok doon sa urban. You know why? Hindi na masyadong na-train ang army sa urban areas. Although na meron training, but then not yung hindi kagaya ng mga police na yun ang training nila. Ang training ng army is in the jungle. Jungle ang expertise ng mga army troops natin. Kaya kaya naman, but the question is basta sa mga semi-urban areas, yung urban na sinasabi dun sa Marawi, kuha na yun, city yun eh. Kaya medyo nahirapan pumasok noon ang operating troops natin sa Marawi. Although na nakapasok, na kuha lahat yung namatay lahat yung mga ISIS sa Marawi, but we suffered also a heavy casualty because medyo hindi na train ng urban areas yung ibang troops natin sa AFP. Well, we accomplished the mission. They accomplished the mission, but then we suffered also a heavy casualty. F, perform operations under limited visibility. Ano ba yung tinatawag na limited visibility? Ha? Kung zero visibility, kung if I'm going to mention about zero visibility during night time yan, dark, very dark. Pero yung mga limited visibility na sinasabi, ha? Yung medyo may fogs, ma-dark konti na. Kaya that's why yung condition is darkness, meron fogs, di ba? Meron rain, meron smoke, ha? Yung dust or any battlefield yung obscurant that may employ clouds and smoke. Yan ang tinatawag natin limited visibility. They can perform operation under limited visibility. Then next is conduct other operations like short range, anti-armor offensives, air assault, amphibious riverine, and in conjunction with heavy forces. They can conduct operations like short range, yung anti-armor, meron tinatawag na sa platoon, may dala sila yung anti-armor, offensive, siyempre, yung troops kasi, yung anti-personnel, na tinatawag yung APC, Army Personnel Carrier, yan ang tawag natin yung parang tanki ba, pero walang kwan yun, 50 caliber lang ang nakalagay doon sa APC, yung anti-armor natin, para sa offensive. Yung air assault na sinatabi, pag nag-request, kung in case na na-encircle ang kalaban, just like when we were in Kakar, that was 1975, we are being surrounded by the Muslim rebels sa Kakar, Maguindanao. So we requested for air assault. Nag-request kami kay hindi na pwede na uncircle kami ng 150 na kalaban. We have 2 casualties. 14 lang kami. Scout Ranger 'yon, ha. Hindi ito rifle squad. Inaano ko kaya kung mangyari rin sa squad, sa infantry battalion doon, ganun din ang gagawin. Magre-request din sila ng air support in order that we can get out sa killing zone. Kasi pag pumasok ka sa killing zone ng kalaban, you are considered dead. Ando doon ka na eh. Kaya you are being surrounded, so we requested for air assault na tinatawag natin yan. Then amphibious. Ano ba yung tinatawag amphibious? Yung riverine. Meron din yung mga scuba. Train din ito. Ito yung mga Navy. No? na expertise, yung Blue Seal na tinatawag nila sa US. Meron din tayo yung dito sa, anong tawag dito sa Navy, yung kung nila, mga special units nila na, ha? Napsol. Oh, yun, ano?
Napsol.
Napsol, yan. Yan, yun ang katapat din ng Blue Seal. And in conjunction with the heavy forces, kung malakas na yung kalaban. Now, example yung mama pasap, mama sa panum masaker, ha? Doon naman nag-failure ang SAP natin. The fact na they never coordinated, nakakaawa yung SAP 44 because they conduct a platoon or more than two platoons, I think. The SAP conducted the two platoon operation in order to capture Marwan. Although they accomplished the mission, but they almost all of that two platoons, huh? More than one platoon pala yun. One platoon. 44 eh. 44 yung, kung alam nyo yung nangyari dun sa mama sa Panong Masaker. More than one platoon of that na patay lahat yun. Only two. Dalawa lang yata ang survivor. You know why? Wala. They never coordinated. Hindi alam ng troops. Mga pulis yun. Oh. In fact, when the president mentioned na meron naman mga helicopters sa tabi, malapit lang. Meron naman infantry battalions. Meron naman brigade sa mga paligid noon. Why? They never coordinated to the armed forces of the Philippines. So yun ang until now humihingi ng justice yung mga parents ng SAP 44 na during the time of President Aquino. So, sino ba yung kwandon responsible sa operation? Si General Napinas. Pero kung if you are a leader, sino ba yung chief, yung commander-in-chief during that period? President Aquino. So, sino yung accountable during that period? Of course, the president. Siya man ang commander-in-chief. So, they never requested for air assault. Anti-armor. Wala sila. Wala pa. Meron na lately. Meron na yung pag-recover ng mga patay. Nag-request yan sila ng amphibious, yung riverine, yung Navy. So, that's why yung ibang mga troops ng PNP nakalabas. So yun, sinasite ko lang yung example ng platoon operations, yung short trains, but then the question is sila ang na-surprise. Pero namatay si Marwan doon. They accomplished their mission, but almost everybody, only two survive in that operations. Well, until now, under investigation, yun lang maikwento ko sa inyo, yung 44 Special Action Force of the Philippine National Police suffered a heavy casualty. Yun ang hindi pa nila nabigyan ng justisya according sa mga parents sa mga namatay. But in the army way of life, kahit paka isang company ang mamatay, wala, no problem yan sa amin. Maraming mga army noon na mamatay na not only isang platoon, kundi more than that. Well, that's in the army way of life. You are expendable, niya sinasabi. Okay, yun ang number 9, na the capabilities ng ating squad and platoons. Limitations. Alam mo, may mga limitations din tayo. Ikaw, cadets, tayo, everybody, may mga limitations. Kagaya rin ng infantry platoon and squad is entirely dependent on the battalion and the company headquarters. Very dependent kasi infantry platoon is under sa company. Under sa battalion. Oh, di ba? From battalion, meron silang tinatawag natin na three companies or four companies, Alpha, Bravo, Charlie, Delta. That is under battalion, no? Oh, Delta. Sa company, meron naman tinatawag na first platoon, second platoon, third platoon, fourth platoon, weapons platoon. Ganon. Oh, may company headquarters. Oh, ito na. Yung limitations. Unit level administration. Hanggang dun lang sa company yan, yung platoon. Ha? Yung infantry platoon sa unit level. Ano yung unit level? Sa under siya ng company. Oh, kung Alpha ka, you belong to Alpha, you belong to Bravo, Charlie up to India, kagaya sa inyo ngayon, you are organized into 10 companies. Then kaya ilan companies tayo up to hotel, no? Ha? Hanggang Juliet. Oh, up to Juliet tayo, unit level, under kayo ng batalyon, meron ngayon sa company, under tayo ng batalyon. Supply, yung supply is dyan lang tayo humihingi sa company. Yung platoon is dyan lang humihingi ako ng supply. Hindi ka pwedeng humingi sa higher up. Yun lang mga limitations natin. Kung ano ibibigay ng company, yun lang. Maliit na supply. Pagkain ba? I-relief ng ita, iuhulog lang ba yung sa helicopter yung dry rations ninyo? Kunti lang. No? Then unit number C is unit level maintenance of communication equipment. Hanggang doon lang sa company. Kung hindi na maabot yun, hindi na tayo makakapag-request doon sa batalyon. It's up to the company to request a higher, a high-tech communication and equipment sa higher up. Yung transportation, very kung tayo. The platoon is very dependent sa company kung wala rin maibigay ng company. Kung konti, wala man tayo sasakyan. It's up to the company mag-request, pero hanggang doon lang sa company tayo nagre-rely. Oh. Diyan kagaya sa inyo, diyan kayo sa company commander ninyo magre-rely. Medical support. Oh, meron na konti. Diyan sa amin, sa una, yung medical support namin, meron kami tinatawag na medical aid man sa platoon. Diyan lang. Kung hindi na makabigay ng gamot yung company, well, yun ang limitations natin. Kung konti, wala man ibinigay doon sa taas. Sa amin, when I was in Hulo, Sulok, meron kaming medical aid man. Every morning yan, nagbibigay, tinatawag natin ng kamukin. Kamukin is anti-malaria. Yun ang kontrang-kontra ko yan, cadets, yung kamukin na yan. Every morning, pupunta, iikot ngayon yung medical aid man namin. Oh, mag-take. Bahala na. Ayaw ko kuminsan. Pero maganda rin kung nag-take ka para hindi ka tatamaan ng malaria. Yan. Mortar, fire support. Well, i-explain ko after this because any company, meron tinatawag na platoon, meron din tinatawag namin doon sa platoon na weapons platoon. May mortar dala-dala yan. Andito may picture, yung dinala ko yung aking picture na company na meron doon na weapons platoon. I will just explain this after this. Sa kuha natin. As we go on in our lecture, makikita nyo mamaya yung mga picture dyan na under sa company yung platoon. Na. Alright. We will continue. Let's go now to different movement formation and techniques. Dito na tayo. Dumadarating na tayo sa ating mga movement and formations techniques of squad and platoon. Okay. Movement. Movement is the shifting of forces while conducting operations in the battlefield. Oh, yan. Forces while conducting operations. Movement yan, ha? Pero yung movement mo, kailangan hindi rin maingay. Okay. This activity involves the selection of the type of formation and movement technique. Oh. type of formation and movement technique that will be employed by leaders, which is entirely dependent on the analysis of the METD. This is MET is under to sa taas factors itong kung ito, ina-analyze ito ng ating higher up. The fire team squad and platoon have their respective peculiar formations. Leaders based in their selection of a particular movement technique on the likelihood of the enemy contact and the requirement of speed. Okay, nandito na tayo. Sige. Like formations, movement techniques provide varying degrees of control, no? Security and flexibility. However, movement techniques differ from formation in two ways. Oh, ayan na, yung movement techniques differ from formation. Iba yung movement techniques, iba rin yung formations. In two ways. Letter A. Formations are relatively fixed. Oh, fixed na yung formation, no? Ito nagpo-formation tayo. Movement techniques are not the distance between moving units. In using movement technique varies based on factors. Based on kung ito ah, sa MET na ginawa dun sa higher up. Letter B. Formations allow the platoon to wait its maximum firepower in a desired direction. While movement techniques allow units to make a contact with the enemy with the smallest element possible. Yan ang diferensya. Yung movement techniques allow unit to make contact while the maximum firepower in the desired direction, yan tinatawag natin, with the smallest element possible. This allows leaders to establish a base of fire, initiate suppressive fires, and attempt to maneuver without first having to disengage or be reinforced. Meron yung tinatawag sa squad na Team A and Team B. Mamaya, makikita nyo sa illustration dun sa example natin sa libro dito sa atin para makita nyo yung Team A and Team B na dun sa rifle squad. Nandoon ngayon yung Team Alpha and Team Bravo. Kung paano mag-bounce yung security, no? Bounce muna, firepower versus pag-bounce ng Team Bravo. Okay. Squad formation. Oh, nandito na tayo sa squad formation na. Oh. Squad. The squad leader is responsible for choosing the most appropriate formation for the squad. He will weigh his decision based on the requirements of the mission and security. Squad formation describes the relationship between fire teams in the squad. There are three types of squad formation, column, line, and file. You know, it's really very hard to become a squad leader because a squad leader is responsible for whatever the team does or fails to do. Ako, namatayan na ako ng dalawa, but still, I'm responsible for that. Eh, kagustuhan ko ba yan na may mamatay na tao ko? But then, we accomplish the mission. Ganon, ito ng mga, well, sa Ranger yun, no? Dito, this is where talking about infantry battalions, rifle squad. Organized by 9 men, but scout ranger is we are only 7. That's why iba. Kino-correlate ko lang, no? So meaning to say, itong rifle squad, meron tinatawag nating Alpha team and Bravo team. Kung minsan yung squad leader nasa center, kung minsan yung squad leader nandoon sa second. Yan. There are 3 types of squad formation: column, line, and file. Tignan natin yung example. Yan. Ano itong kwa natin, yung formation na ito? CPO, taga CPO, cadets ito ha. Cadets, this group, nung 2018 ito, 2018, yung mga babae, karamihan dito babae, kaya ilan lang lalaki dyan. Oh, this is sa Rifle Squad of Central Philippine University. Itong tinatawag na line formation. Pero during night time ito, kung taxing distance, during night time movement ito, pero pagka 6 paces apart in line formation, during daytime yan. Ito lang, in example ko lang ito sa inyo, ito yung rifle squad. This is a squad. Okay? The squad column. The squad column is the squad most common formation, particularly in open terrain. Open terrain, ha? It provides good dispersion laterally in depth without sacrificing control and facilitate maneuver. The lead fire team is the base fire team. Lead fire team, yung alpha. Alpha team yun. Ha? Kasi 9 yan eh. There are 9. Alpha team composed of 1, 2, 3, 4. Bravo team, 1, 2, 3, 4. The squad leader is at the center. Ika-9 yun. When the squad moves independently, independent yan ha, meaning to say, hindi dependent sa company. Hindi dependent sa platoon. Hindi, kayo lang, nga 9. Or as the rear element of the platoon, the rifleman in the trail, fire team provides rear security. Meaning to say, kung ikaw yung nasa last, rear security is my responsibility. Ikaw ngayon magsisecure sa likod. Para kung makapasok, kung minsan, itong enemy, wise yung enemy, papasukin muna kayo doon sa loob bago kayo bakbakan dito sa rear. Yan ang nakuha namin technique nung when I was in Hulo. Papasok ka muna sa loob. Pag nasa loob ka na ng jungle, doon ka babakbakan sa likod. Rear. Kaya that's why yung rear palagi na pag-aralan namin every time na mag-conduct ng kami ng operations, doon palagi pinapapasok kami, babakbakan kami doon sa puwet. Puwet ang tinatawag rear. But then, in the long run, napapag-aralan namin, okay, maka-counter din namin how to maneuver to the left or to the right. Okay. Yan. Squad column, look at this. Ito yung tinatawag natin na squad column cadets. The team leader is a point man and doon sa kwan. Going that way, ha? The automatic rifleman, the grenadier. Yan may, itong grenadier na tinatawag, dala-dala niya mga explosive yan. And of course, compass. You will be expert in using this compass and map. Yung map, dahil paano kayo makaka-reach ng objective without knowing map? Map is a graphical representation of the Earth's surface drawn to scale as seen, in map, as seen from the above. Compass, para at least malocate mo yung enemy. The rifleman. Tignan nyo yung rifleman. Going up yan, ha? And the squad leader, team leader, ha? Ito yung team leader alpha, nakikita nyo yan, yung una is team alpha, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, team bravo, dito sa likod, this is what we called squad column. Alam mo kung face to face lang tayo, mapipicture out ninyo kung paano mag-move. Yan ang ginagawa namin dito sa ground ng Central Philippine University. Every Saturday, meron kaming demonstration ng mga squad. Yung tinatawag small unit tactics. Kaya ito. Ito yung ginagamit natin sa tactical inspection. Competing different universities entire Visayas. Pero sa awa ng Diyos, si PU palagi ang nagna-number one. Palagi sa tactical inspection. Especially small unit tactics. Nakita ninyo, uulitin ko, team leader, point man, magiging point man, iyan ang tinatawag na alpha team. 1, 2, 3, 4. The squad leader at the center and the bravo team nasa likod. Ito. Iyan ang mga position sa rifle squad. Okay. If you have some clarification later on, you try to post your questions dito sa kuha natin online na lecture kasi hindi natin ma-answeran ka agad niyan dahil sa dami ninyo. Okay, next formation. Okay, dito itong tinatawag na squad line. Okay, the squad line provide maximum firepower to the front when a squad is acting as the base squad of the platoon. The fire team on the right is the base fire team. All right. Ito yung sinatawag na alpha team and bravo team. Tingnan ninyo ngayon. Ito yung tinatag line, going up yan ha. Ha? Yan ang line formation. Yung kalaban nandito sa up. Ah. Team leader, automatic rifleman, grenadier, rifleman, squad leader. Itong compose ito dito sa left side, Bravo team. Ito naman sa right side is Alpha team. Ah. Look at the illustration. Ito na kuan ito dito sa kuan natin. Oh. Anyway, later on na makikita niyo naman yung ano, iiwanan lang naman dito, meron naman kay kopya nito eh. Okay, next. Squad file. Yung squad file naman, ito yung palagi namin pag mag-move out sa daytime or during night time yung squad file. Ito yung normal na formation of the squad or a platoon. Maski company, ganun din. When not traveling in a column or line, squad travels in file. The squad file has the same characteristic as the fire team file. The squad leader may position himself at the front. Squad leader yun ha, kung gusto niya. He may select his own position. Second in position, if he decides to increase his control over the formation. You know why? Para makontrol niya yung squad. Especially kung meron ng bakbakan sa front. Exert greater leadership presence to be immediately available to make a decision. To provide additional control over the rear of the formation, a team leader can be positioned at the second to the last position of the squad formation. Itong palagi namin na experience, yung meeting engagement, cadets. I experienced this meeting engagement in Isabela. Isabela, San Mariano, Isabela. No casualty, but we captured at least 8 M16 rifle. Meeting engagement, meaning to say, nagkasalubong. Ha? Well, technique yun namin sa mga scout ranger, although na this is not in infantry, but not only infantry. Yung infantry, doon din kami sa hulo noon, kukwento ko rin yung experience namin sa Panamaw, hulo. When we encountered doon sa Panamaw, meeting engagement pa rin. Ganon. Although we have a casualty, si Lieutenant taga-Tigbawan yon, si Lieutenant Torrelaviga. Yes, I remember that Lieutenant Torrelaviga. Nasa squad file kami, squad file yon. Then biglang pumutok doon sa front, tamaan kagad si Lieutenant Torrelaviga. But then buhay man siya. Then we we maneuver. Ginuha namin siya continuous for 5 hours encounter, bakbakan. We suffered at least 3 casualties only for the enemies. Nakapasok na kami doon sa loob, nag-request na kami ng air support. Hindi naman pwede na hindi kami mag-request ng air support kay nandoon kami sa loob. Sa loob, meaning to say, sa loob kami ng kalaban, sa ground ng kalaban. Ganon ang technique ng kalaban, papapasukin kayo doon sa loob bago babakbakan kayo doon, left and right, rear. Alam mo kung saan yung sniper nila? Cadets? Nandun lahat doon sa taas ng nyog. Nakatali na yung baywang nila. Kaya kung matamaan mo yung sniper nila doon sa nyog, nakabitin na lang. Hindi nahuhulog yung patay nila or casualty. So, ganun. Yung squad file, palagi yan nangyayari, yung squad file meeting engagement. Okay? Ito yung tinatawag na squad file. Papunta doon sa app. Expect na bakbakan sa front yan. Pagputok doon sa unahan, sasabayan dito sa left side, titirahin na kapag nakapasok na kayo doon sa loob. Anticipated na namin yan. Anticipated, that's why we careful on maneuvering left or right. Wala sila sa right. Kung minsan nasa front, nasa right side sila. Kung minsan nasa front, nasa left side sila. So that's why analyze the situation, then nagmamaneuver na yung squad. Okay? Yan ang squad file na tinatawag na formation. Ito, yung sunod-sunod ba? Yung sunod-sunod. Okay, any question? At least, kuhan kayo. Alam nyo na kung ano yung mga different formation of the squad. So, before we will continue, let's have a 5 minutes break. Alright, cadets, we will continue, no? Dito pa rin tayo sa formation. Look at this, comparisons of squad formation. Tignan niyo ito. Type, wear, use, control, flexibility, fire capabilities, restrictions, no? Then security. Column. Squad primary formation, good, facilitates maneuver, good dispersion laterally and in depth, allows large volume of fire to the flank, limited volume to the fire. Pero kailangan pinaka-importante, if you are already very self-explanatory ito, no? If you are already in the area, ito ang pinaka-importante sa lahat, security. You know why? Huwag magre-relax. Never relax. The moment you rest, mag-rest kayo sa isang lugar during after operations, don't forget security. Just like you, cadets. Pag umuwi kayo galing sa kung saan-saan lugar, palagi kailangan maging security conscious kayo. Yung pinupuntahan niyo, secured ba yung area? Pag-uwi mo pagkagabi, security pa rin yung nasa isip mo. Pag sumakay ka ng taxi, security. Reminders to all of you. Pag sumasakay kayo ng taxi, number one ang gagawin nyo is get the plate number. No? Ilista nyo, i-text nyo agad sa parents ninyo, sa kapatid ninyo, sa kaibigan ninyo, yung plate number na sinasakyan ninyo ng taxi. O, pagsakay ninyo kaagad, yung plate number kaagad yung i-text ninyo. Security. That's security. Mahirap na maisahan ka. Baka sabihin mo, kuhan naman. At saka, you should appreciate a piece of information. That is security. A piece information na ganito, mayroon kang kuhan daw. Ganito, haharangin ka. Tapos meron sumusubaybay sa inyo. Meron na pag naka-receive ka ng mga impormasyon na ganon, be security conscious. Appreciate that piece of information. Kaya security from time to time. Again, I repeat, kahit saan kayo pumunta, be security conscious. Cadets, sa kaligtasan nyo yan. Ha? Huwag niyong i-ignore yan. Hindi maganda. Basta mas maganda yung palaging nasa ulo niyo about security. O, self-explanatory. Itong comparison of squad formation. Next tayo. O, platoon formation. Dito na tayo sa platoon formation. Ito, pinakamahirap ito kung minsan yung sa operations itong platoon cadets. Because mantakin mo yan. Controlling a platoon leader, platoon sergeant, squad leader, sa apat na squad ang kukontrolin mo. Platoon formation. In platoon formation, the leader should wait carefully to select the best formation based on his mission. O, yun nga. Yung platoon leader na yan. There are 6 platoon formations. Column, line, with squads on line yan. With squad on column, then V. Yung V na tinatawag yung victory, wedge, and file. Andyan sa, kuwan mamaya, drawing dito sa illustration natin sa ating computer. Next. Example of infantry battalion ito. 11 infantry battalion company. Oh, look at this. Andiyan ako. No? Sa Mindanao operation, andiyan ako. I belong to Charlie Company, 11th Infantry Battalion, Alpha Bravo Charlie. There are only three companies in our battalion before dahil kukunti pa ang sundalo. Oh. I belong to 3rd Platoon. Hmm? Ay, 1st Platoon ba ako noon? Basta nandito ako. 3rd Platoon. Oh, I belong to 3rd Platoon. Nandiyan ako. Ayan o. Sa first squad. Ito yung tinatawag na company. Ito naman tinatawag na platoon. Ito nakikita nyo cadets. First platoon under second lieutenant Lumang. Second platoon under second lieutenant Tayona. And third platoon under lieutenant Lim. I belong to third platoon. Sa first squad ako. First squad. Hindi dyan ako. Yan. No, nung panahon pa yan namin. That's why, pinalitrato ko ito para makita nyo, ma-picture ninyo kung ano yung company at saka mga platoon. Meron tinatawag dito na company headquarters dyan. Itong company headquarters, nandoon lang sila sa command post, nagmaman ng kung ano nangyayari, minomonitor nila yung first platoon, second platoon, third platoon, kung ano nangyayari na. Ito yung when the first platoon was deployed sa Lilyungan, Cotabato. Lilyungan, North Cotabato. Yung second platoon na-deploy ito sa Rancho Midsayap, North Cotabato. Sa amin, third platoon was deployed doon sa Barangay Aroman, Carmen, North Cotabato. Kung sino yung mga taga Carmen, Cotabato, alam nila kung ano yung Carmen, Cotabato. That was way back 1972 pa ito. Oh. Yan. Ang example, kaya dinadala ko yung, kaya I'm talking with experience nga eh. Yan nasabi ko, baka hindi to ako pag nagle-lecture, ayaw ko yan ang bubula. I'm talking with experience. And of course, we have the book, guides, na dinidiscuss natin. Pero, yung actual na encounter, kung minsan, magwatak-watak kami because of volume of fire. That's why yung mga different formation, nawawatak. Pag kulong, pag sabi nila, hindi napapalo because of volume of fire. Buti kung open terrain yan, madali lang. Ano kung open terrain, di lalong maraming patay? That's why I'm talking here yung na-experience ko regarding sa different kinds of formation. In Medsayap, doon kami sa Tunganon, we suffered heavy casualties. Our platoon leader, si First Lieutenant Ignacio, Jaime Ignacio from Tansa, Iloilo, was hit on the spot, sa ulo, patay. Kaagad kami doon sa Tunganon, Midsayap, North Cotabato. And PFC, Private First Class Arsenal from Haniway, Iloilo, was also hit at his left breast. And after 2 hours, namatay siya. So 2 casualties namin sa Tunganon noon. The platoon leader and isang private first class under second platoon. I say third platoon, second squad, si Arsenal. Andito siya patay. Kaya that's why itong squad na ito, kwan pala, company ito, dinala ko para at least mapicture nyo kung ano yung mga platoon. Oh, okay? Ayan. First platoon, under 11th Infantry Battalion, Charlie Company pala, under 11th Infantry Battalion, second platoon, third platoon. Tatlo lang kumpanya kasi dahil ko konti pang army. Para ma-picture nyo. Meron tinatawag dito na weapon squad. Weapon squad, any platoon. Alam mo yung mga dala-dala nito? Caliber M60 or caliber 30. machine gun at saka mortar. Yung mortar 60, yung 60 yung maliit 60 millimeter na mortar na nadadala. Tapos ang bigat yung mga bala. Yan ang tinatawag namin weapon squad. Pag nag-operation ang platoon, ito yung kaligtasan namin to, dahil magpo-position sila sa isang area. Pag nag-encounter, nagmamachine gun sila at nagmumortar. Ito, mga weapons squad na tinatawag namin. So, mapicture nyo na, kades, kung ano yung first platoon, second platoon, third platoon. Meron first squad, second squad, third squad, and weapons squad. Oh, see, nakita nyo na. Sige, next. Platoon column. This formation is the platoon's primary movement formation. It provides good dispersion both laterally and depth and simplifies control. The lead squad is the base squad. Itong platoon, ang control nito, ang deployment nito is by squad. Hindi by Alpha Team at saka Bravo Team, no. Sa by squad, but then, it depends the sa team, sa squad leader na meron din siyang Alpha Team at saka Bravo Team. Pag sinabing first squad, occupy the left side. Oh. Second squad, occupy the rear squad. Dali lang, excuse me. Yung platoon, meron din ang platoon, it depends kung pag-deploy niya by squad. Oh, pag sabi niya ngayon, first squad, occupy the left side or the higher ground. Second squad, occupy the rear. Third squad, pag sabi na, doon ka sa right side. Oh. Weapon squad, occupyin mo yung pinaka-highest sa yung may commanding ground. Yung may commanding ground na tinatawag natin, cadets, is yung pinaka-highest doon sa tuktok ng bundok para makapag-machine gun siya or makapag-mortar. Ngayon, yung squad naman, pag-deploy sa kanya, bahala na ang squad leader kung okay, Alpha Team. Oh, dito ka, pag-maneuver natin, Bravo Team, pag-maneuver natin. Ganon ang plastada ng platoon. As I've said, meron apat na squad in platoon. Okay? Oh, sige. Yan. Platoon column formation. Tingnan ninyo yan. Platoon leader, nandito siya sa gitna. By squad to, 2, 4, 6, 8, 9. Oh, per squad, dito sa taas. Itong second squad, dito sa kwan. Oh, tingnan ninyo. Oh. Magulo yung platoon, but then ang control yan, platoon leader. Ha? Ang control. Ang kinokontrol lang ng platoon leader, cadets, are the squad leaders in a platoon. Hindi niya kukontrolin ngayon, hindi siya magkukumand-kumand sa mga members ng squad, kundi ang tatawagin niya lang yung mga squad leader. Oh, kung ma-imagine ninyo, if you are designated as platoon leader, ang kontrolin mo, squad leader. Ganun yon. Oh, platoon in column formation, ito, kung makikita ninyo. Oh, lead squad, center squad, trail squad. Oh. Pero walang weapon squad dito. Sige, next. Oh, platoon line. Line with squad line. This formation allows the delivery of maximum firepower to the front but little fire to the flank. This formation is hard to control and does not facilitate rapid movement. For control purposes, the platoon leader must designate a base squad when conducting operation independently. So, meron din base squad. Hindi yung Alpha Team, Bravo Team, kundi squad. Oh, squad ang kukontrol na mayroon base of fire. Kung halimbawa, na base of fire, mag-secure, then tatakbo naman yung isang squad sa isang area para at least ma-secure natin yung isang squad habang nagbabakbakan. However, if the platoon is designated by the company commander as the base platoon, the platoon center squad is base squad. When the platoon is not acting as the base platoon, its base squad is its flank squad. Company commander ang control. Kung company commander control, platoon ang kinokontrol niya. Yun naman ang platoon leader ang kukontrolin ng company commander. So, designated company base platoon, the machine gun can move with the platoon or they can support by fire from a support position This formation is the platoon's basic assault formation. Hindi nyo masyado maintindihan ito dahil siyempre hindi na nakikita yung deployment ng bawat platoon if company control. Ipipicture nyo na lang na ang company is tatlong platoon. Ang kukontrolin ng company commander is platoon leader, bawat platoon. And the platoon, kontrolin niya lang naman yung squad leaders. Nakukuha natin ha. Alright. Ito, platoon line formation. Tignan mo yung mga platoon. Line form, this is one platoon. Left flank squad. Center squad. Right flank squad. Oh, are you following, cadets? Tignan nyo mabuti. This is a platoon line formation. Next. Oh, platoon B. Tignan nyo yung platoon B. Oh. Oh. Ito yung tinatawag natin. This formation has to squad up front to provide a heavy volume of fire and on contact. It is also has one squad in the rear that can either overwatch or trail the other squad. This formation is hard to control. Movement is slow. The platoon leader designate one of this front squad to be the platoon's base squad. Talaga mahirap kontrolin ito, especially pag nagbakbakan. This is a company platoon control. Ha? Yung V. Platoon control, this is not a company control. Oh, look at this V. Tinatawag na the first squad sa left, second squad, then nasa center, oh, then fourth squad, nasa baba, center squad. Nandito doon. Oh, these are the different formation. Kung ipipicture ninyo ngayon, oh, if you are designated as platoon leader, talagang mahirap kontrolin kung nagbakbakan yan. Kung walang bakbakan, okay lang. Sitting pretty kayo. Eh, pag nagbakbakan yan, oh, isa lang kontrolin lang, okay. Wait for my instruction, pag sabi ng platoon leader. So yung squad leader ngayon naghihintay ng instruction ng kung ano yung next gagawin nila. Depende sa platoon leader decisions. See, it's really very hard, you know, if you are in the battlefield. You are responsible, if you are a leader, you are responsible for whatever the platoon does or fails to do. Mali ng squad. Mali mo as platoon leader. See? Yan ang leadership. Yan. Andi dyan na pumapatong na yung kuha na yan, leadership. Next. Platoon wedge. Ito, meron din kami tinatawag sa squad wedge. Ano? Ito yung wedge na sinasabi. This formation has two squad in the rear. Dalawang squad sa rear. Ito importante kasi sa rear. Di ba sinasabi ko sa inyo, bago kayo papasok sa isang area, pinapapasok kayo ng kalaban, doon kayo babakbakan. Kaya napag-aralan sa taas na palaging yung squad ngayon nandoon ngayon sa likod para in preparation kung pinapasok kayo, if you are being surrounded by the enemy, lahat nakapag-prepare. Although nandoon na kayo sa killing zone. Killing zone ang tawag niyan eh. Ito yung tinatawag na killing zone, nandun kayo sa loob. Na, nag-designate na ang kalaban ng killing zone, pinapasok kayo, kaya ang rear nandun sa likod. It allows the platoon leader to make contact with the squad still have one or two squad to maneuver. The lead squad is the base squad. Ah, yan ang tinatawag. Lead squad ang base squad yun. Para na pinaka-security. Bakbakan yan para makapasok yung ibang squad. Next. Yan. Platoon file. Ito yung file na platoon. Oh. Meron tinatawag yan na flank security. Meron tinatawag din na kuhan yan. Team yan. Ah. Alpha team and Bravo team. Nah. This formation be set up in several method. One method is to have three squad. Squad file follow one another using one of the movement techniques. Another method is to have a single platoon file with the front security element and flank security element. This formation is used when visibility is poor. Ano yung kuhan? Yung poor visibility, yung zero, yung dark, very dark. Hindi naman very dark, kundi poor visibility, yung nakikitang hindi masyado yung makikita yung mga kasama mo. Due to terrain. Oh, yung poor visibility is due to terrain. May mga fogs, may mga ano. Vegetation, yung mga different kinds of plant. Kasi nandi dyan kayo sa loob, or light conditions. The distance between soldiers is less than normal to allow communication by passing messages up and down the file. The platoon file has the same characteristic as the fire team and squad file. Alam nyo, mahirap nyong intindihin yan dahil you are not an army. You are not belong to the service. Ako, maintindihan ko ito. You know why? Because of my experience. Because I'm a soldier. Sundalo ako. Retired ko. Kaya alam ko kung saan ito. Napag-aralan namin lahat ito. Kayo mga cadets, at least mayroon kayo i-imaginin nyo ngayon, iisipin nyo kung ganito pala. May rear security, may flank security, mayroon naman na front security, ito pala yung file. So at least, mayroon na kayong idea kung paano ang platoon pag-designate ng company commander ng platoon at may platoon leader, kung paano ngayon na pag they are given a mission, ano ba yung formation na gagamitin? Alam na ng platoon leader yan. Kami, alam na namin kung anong dapat gagawin. But you, cadets na hindi pa nyo napag-aralan, at least binibigyan kayo namin ng idea kung paano nito. Yung mga different formation. Okay? Next. Platoon formation comparison. Tignan ninyo. Type, where, column. Sige, I will just... Tignan niyo, basahin ninyo ito. Enemy situation. May mga enemy situation dito eh. Column, platoon priming movement, good for maneuver, provide good dispersion laterally depth. Allows limited firepower to rear high volume to the flank. Movement, good. Slow. Line, squad line. Line, squad line in column. Where use? Platoon primary for maximum firepower to the front and the enemy situation none. Prepare for contact when crossing the LD long distance and is near objective. Ito naman, file V wedge, yung different natin, yung formation V wedge. When visibility of poor due terrain or light condition, when enemy situation flexibility, most difficult formation from which to maneuver. To squat, front form, immediate, firepower. Okay, I'll just leave this to you. You read this platoon formation comparison. And we'll go to the next. Movement techniques. Ito yung movement techniques na naman tayo. Sa movement tayo, ha? Formation kanina, sa movement naman. A movement technique is the manner by which a platoon uses to traverse over a terrain. Ano ba yung tinatawag na traverse? Meron tayong tinatawag na traverse dito. Yung mga travel across, di ba? Yung traverse is travel across over a terrain. Rugged terrain or maganda na terrain. Ano ba yung mga terrain dyan sa bundok? Di ba? Puro rugged dyan. Napakahirap ang terrain dyan. Ang kalaban, kabisado nila. Pero AFP, hindi. Yung mga troops natin, army, they are not familiar with the terrain, but the enemy, familiar sila sa terrain. There are three movement techniques. Traveling overwatch, and bounding overwatch. The selection of the movement technique is based on the likelihood of enemy contact and the need for speed. Factors to consider for each technique and air control. Dispersion, speed, and security. Yung squad, meron tinatawag na na Alpha Team and Bravo Team. Kaya nga, depende yan. Pag sinabi ng squad leader, move! Alpha Team, mag-move muna, while the Bravo Team, act as the security or habang tumatakbo sa kwan, sa isang position ang Alpha Team, ang Bravo Team will act as the security. Ganun yun. Next. Movement techniques are not fixed formation. Hindi yung fix, ha? Hindi fiction. They are referred to distances between soldiers, teams, and squad that may vary based on mission. Anyway, terrain, visibility, and any other factors that affect control. In all situations, soldier must be able to see their fire team leader. Oh, ha? Yung soldiers talaga, the squad leader must be able to see his fire team leaders. Oh. Yung squad leader talaga ang mag-ano, titignan niya ngayon mga Alpha team or Bravo team, yung team leaders. The platoon leader should be able to see his lead squad. Leader. Ito, yung control ito is platoon. Leaders control movement with an arm and hand signals. May mga hand signals kami. Kung halimbawa, pinapapunta mo yung platoon leader, may mga hand signals kami na ginagamit. They use radios only when needed. Any of the three movement techniques, traveling overwatch, bounding overwatch, can be used with any formation. Alam mo, sa pagpunta nyo dun sa objective, kuminsan, puros hand signal para hindi kayo ma-detect ng mga kalaban. Okay. Type traveling overwatch, bounding overwatch. Where use conduct not likely, contact possible. Contact is expected sa bounding overwatch. Expected yan. Control, more, less, most. Dispersion, less, more, most. Fastest, slowest, less. Security palagi. Ang importante. Next. Yan. Ito na yung squad movement techniques. The platoon leader determines and direct which movement technique the squad will use. Depende na yan sa platoon. Platoon leader, squad will use. The decision are governed by the following. Traveling. This technique is used when contact with the enemy is not likely and speed is needed. Mabilis. Ha? Ito yung squad. Going that way. Automatic rifleman, team leader, yan, Alpha team and Bravo team sa baba. Squad leader, center. Traveling. Ha? Next. Ito traveling overwatch. Itong tina-disuse when contact is possible. Itong ginagamit pagka meron ng contact with the enemy. Contact front. Contact left. Contact right. Ambos ba? Meron kang immediate action ka talaga. Attached weapon are placed near the squad leader and under his control so he can employ them quickly. Traveling overwatch yan. Ha? Next. Bounding overwatch. Yung tinatawag na pupunta mo na yung Team Alpha, then Bravo will suppress the enemy. Bounding overwatch is used when contact is expected. Yan na. When the squad leader feels the enemy is near, through movement, noise, reflection, thrust, malapit na yung kalaban, when large open danger, area must be crossed. One, the lead fire team overwatch. Lead fire team muna yung kuna, pupunta overwatch siya. First, then soldier can scan. Tinitignan nila kung saan yung mga kalaban for enemy position. Number two, the trail fire team bounce. Trail fire team bounce. Meaning to say, the fire team mag-bounce muna, then signal the squad leader when his team completely it bounce and it's prepared to overwatch the moving team. Para at least, by bounce. Both team leaders must know if successive or alternate bounce will be used and which team our squad leader will be with. Successive bounds are easier to control while alternate bounds can be faster. Forward, bound by bounds yan. Then fire team, forward. Then until such time, ma-bug down na ang enemy. The overwatching team leader must know the route and destination of the bounding team. Siyempre, importante yan. Hindi mo alam. Paano makontrol yan? The bounding team leader must know his team destination and route for possible enemy locations and action to take when arrived there. He must also know where the overwatching team will be and how will receive his instruction. The available cover and concealment along the bounding team route distinct how its soldiers move. Don't forget also about cover and concealment. Cover and concealment. Dahil kung hindi nyo alam yan, very basic eh. What is cover? Correct? Cover is the protection from enemy fire. Diba? Kaya mag-cover ka. While concealment is protection from enemy observation. Oh, na kinoconceal mo yung kwan, nag-cover ka to protect the enemy observation, nag-observe ka kung saan yung kalaban. That's the difference between cover and concealment. Bounding team rope dictates its soldiers move. Okay? Bounding overwatch. Ito, tinatawag oh, yung movement techniques. Successive move. By kwan ito, plat kampanya ito ah, platon. First move. Oh, yan. Fourth move. Security. By bounce yan. By bounce palagi. Alternating bounce. Yan ang mga objective oh. Ah. Next, bounding. Platon. Ito yung tinatawag, platon movement techniques. The platoon leader determines and directs which movement techniques the platoon will use. Traveling. This technique is used when contact with the enemy is not likely and speed is needed. Mabilis. Lead squad in travel and overwatch formation. 20 meters. Platoon headquarters weapon. Ito yung mga illustration ng platoon traveling. But I was not able to experience this company itong kung ano ito, only platoon yung naano ko, platoon movement techniques. Traveling overwatch. Traveling overwatch is used when contact is possible but speed is needed. Palaging mabilis yan ang needed. The platoon leader moves where he can best control the platoon. He move. Para mag-control niya yung first squad, second squad, third squad. The platoon sergeant travels with the trailing squad. True. Although he is free to move throughout the formation to enforce the security, noise and light discipline. Kailangan tayo may combat discipline tayo niyan. Yung light discipline and distance between squad is needed. The lead squad uses traveling overwatch and the trailing squad use traveling. Tingnan niyo to. Next. Bounding overwatch. Movement. Dito pa rin tayo sa movement techniques. Bounding overwatch is used when contact is expected. Platoon conduct bounding overwatch using successive or alternate bounds. By bounds pa rin tayo. May forward bounce. By bounds. Security. Halt, then another, bounce. This technique is done with the following element. One squad bounding, one squad bounce forward to chosen position, mag-choose yan ang position, and then it becomes the overwatching. Pag halt niya, overwatch, secure, then element unless contact is made en route. En route ka doon sa papunta sa kalaban. The bounding squad can use traveling overwatch. Bounding overwatch or individual movement technique. Low and high crawl is needed in this. Alam nyo yung kung kuan crawl talaga para hindi ka matamaan or ma-detect ng kalaban. Ensure traces by fire team or pairs. Number two, one squad overwatches the bounding squad from covered position from where it can see and suppress like enemy position. Para at least ma-suppress mo, ma-knockdown na ang kalaban. At least by bound na secure. May casualty man kayo hindi, basta ma-capture nyo ang objective. Soldiers use scanning techniques to view their assigned sector. The platoon leader remains with the overwatching squad. Normally, the platoon machine gun is located with the overwatching squad. Oh, sinabi ko na. Siyempre, i-position nyo yung machine gun. If in case na nag-fire ang kalaban, makapag-counter yung machine gun natin. One squad awaiting orders. Naghihintay ang orders sa platoon leader. One squad is uncommitted and ready for employment as directed by the platoon leader. Pag-reinforcements, waiting for orders. The platoon sergeant and the leader of the squad awaiting orders position themselves close to the platoon leader. Hintay lang sila ng order for reinforcement. Kung nabagdown na isang squad doon, The platoon leader will order the awaiting squad for reinforcement or to help the one squad. Platoon bounding overwatch. Matignan mo itong illustration, no? Squad awaiting orders. Nandito sa safe na lugar. No? Sa rallying yung point ba? Then bounding squad. Overwatching squad. Oh, bundok-bundok ito ah, tinatawag. Pero at least titingnan niyo yung kung i-picture ninyo ito, imagine ninyo kung ganito pala ang buhay ng sundalo, ha? Movement next. Oh. When deciding where to have his bounding squad go, a platoon leader considers 1. The requirements of the mission. Ano ba talaga yung requirements of the mission? Search and destroy? Kung sinabing your mission is XYZ, ano bang requirements natin? XYZ, search and destroy operation. XYZ meaning to search, combat, where the enemy is likely to be. Ano ba yung kuha ng enemy doon? Ginagawa, the route to the next overwatch position. Yan ang mga i-considers nyan. The ability of an overwatching element, weapons to cover the bound. The responsiveness of the rest of the platoon. Pag in case na ano, na nabag down ang two squad, ano ba yung response ng ibang platoon? Magre-reinforce ba yan sila? Dahil dalawang squad na ang patay. The field of fire at the next overwatch position. So those are the bounding squad platoon leader considered, kinoconsider ng isang platoon leader. Okay. Before a bound, the platoon leader gives an order to his squad leaders from overwatch position. He tells and shows them the following. By the way, cadets, ito control to ng platoons to. Ha? This is a platoon control. Number 1, the direction or location of the enemy. Yan. Yung sinasabing location, the strength of the enemy, the position of the overwatching squad. Anong position yung overwatching, nag-overwatch? Ha? The next overwatch, di ba sinasabi ko there are 4 squad? The next overwatch position, the route of the bounding squad. Yung daan, dadaanan niya, yung route. Yung bounding squad. What to do after the bounding squad reaches the next position? Ano bang dapat gagawin? What signal the bounding squad will use to announce it is prepared to overwatch? Depende na yan sa platoon leader kung ano yung dapat signal ang gagamitin nila. Or through radio ba? Or hand signal? How the squad will receive their next order? Siyempre, palagi ka mag-listen sa squad leader. Depende na yan sa squad leader kung bibigyan ka ng ganito. You occupy the hill 103. Ganon. Kasi, ito na yung tinasabi. Squad leader, platoon sergeant, platoon leader. Platoon, kung ito? Platoon control. Platoon leader, squad leader, squad leader, forward. Di ba sabi ko sa inyo kanina, this is a platoon. Controlled by platoon leader. Lahat dito na nandito is puro squad leader yan. Nagkakandak sila ng OP operation. Ano yung OP operation? Observation post operation to locate the enemy. Ano ba yung requirements doon sa OP operation? Salut. Strength of the enemy. Activity of the enemy. Location of the enemy. Ela, yung salot. Then na time, then na equipment of the enemy, yung salot na sinata, o seldom pala, seldom. Alam niyo, S-E-L-D-O-M. Ano yung ginagawa nito? Seldom. The strength of the enemy, equipment of the enemy, location of the enemy, disposition. Then organization of the enemy and morale of the enemy. Include yung morale. High morale ba yung enemy?
Lumural ba?
Oh. Yan ang ginagawa nila. Actions at danger areas. Dito na tayo sa actions, cadets. Oh. A danger area is any place on a route where the leader's estimate process tells him that his platoon might be exposed to enemy observation. Fire or bot. Platoons try to avoid danger areas. If platoon must cross a danger area, it does not with great caution and as quickly as possible. Pag na-detect kayo ng enemy, wala na. Talo na kayo. Kaya nga, that's why this is a platoon movement. Madali kayo ma-detect dahil ang iingay ko minsan. I experienced it already in Lanao. Kami nag-lead. 6 teams ng Scout Ranger, inilid namin ng isang batalyon, tatlong batalyon. Andudun na kami sa kalaban. We recovered already so many documents at saka mga firearms. Doon pa sa baba, yung mga infantry batalyons dahil ang iingay. Kaya, danger area. How, ano yung gagawin nyo sa mga danger area? Ay, siyempre, silent. Silent in the jungle. Yan nga. Yung sinasabing, very silently in the jungle. So, para hindi kayo ma-expose, hindi kayo marinig ng kalaban. Type of danger areas in crossing procedures. Open areas. Yan ang pinakadelikado. O yung open areas. Bakit ka dadaan sa open areas kung medyo pinakadelikado yan? Conceal the platoon on the near side and observe the area. Doon kayo sa gilid-gilid lang. Never cross the open terrain. Kaya mamamatay kayo. Post security to give early warning. Mag-post ka muna ng security before ka mag-cross kayo doon sa gilid-gilid ng open terrain. Yan ang sinasabi, stand to. Oh, ano yung stand to na sinasabi? Halt, observe muna. Ano yung mga ingay-ingay dyan? Yan ang stand to. Oh, to give early. Send an element across to declare the far side. Oh, for purposes na secured ba yung area, magpadala ka doon. Tignan mo muna doon dahil baka medyo pag-cross ng platoon, delikado tayo. When cleared, let the remainder of the platoon cross the shortest exposed distance as quickly as possible. Pass ang movement kasi ang dinadaanan nyo, open areas. Next. Roads and trails. Yan ang mga delikadong lugar na dadaan, yung roads and trails. Bakit kayo dadaan? Never. Ako, takot ako yan noon araw. Ngayon, bakit tayo dito dadaan? Doon tayo sa pinakamahirap na daan ang dadaanan natin para at least safety tayo. Road and trails. Ito lang yung mga dangers sa crossroad or trail at or near a bend, narrow spot or on low ground. Doon kayo sa gilid-gilid lang ng road or trails. Eh, trails talaga. Alam na dadaanan yan eh. Villages. Nako. Yung villages yan, pagka narinig ka, maraming aso. Villages on the downwind side and well away from them. Avoid animals. Iingay yan, especially dogs, which might reveal the presence of the troops sa village, especially during night time. Enemy positions. Pass on the downwind side. The enemy might have dogs. Be alert for tripwires and warning devices. Diba, nag-lecture na ako ng improvised explosive devices. Be alert for tripwires. Baka naglagay yung kalaban ng mga tripwires, may mga explosive, improvised explosive devices. Fields of improvised explosive devices, bypass field of IEDs as much as possible, even if it's required changing the route by great distance. Clear and patrol fields only if necessary. You know, I remember First Lieutenant Magbanwa of si Central Philippine University, Pradak. He was assigned sa Hulo. Alam mo, yung nanay niya nandyan sa Kwan, nandyan sa, anong pangalan to? Admin. Yung nanay ni First Lieutenant Magbanwa, sinabihan niya ako niya na, my son is not a hero for me. Umiiyak. Dahil parang galit yata sa amin, dahil pinasundalo namin siya. By then, namatay sa improvised explosive device in Hulusulo. That was 4 years ago. 3 years ago later? 3 years ago? Namatay. Kaya medyo may samang loob sa amin yung nanay nito. Dahil dito siya dati, instructor din siya ng ROTC. Because of this, dumaan siya sa nakalimutan niya yung security. That's why doon sumabog, hindi na nakilala, hindi na binuksan yung kabaong niya because wasak yan sa improvised explosive device, cadets. Si First Lieutenant Magbanwa. The mother, kung kilala niyo, nandiyan sa admin. Ngayon, pag nakikita niya ako, umiiyak yan, kaya hindi na ako dumadaan dyan. So, those are the actions in dangerous areas. Ano pa? Meron pa. Oh, streams. Ano ba yung mga streams? Yan, select a narrow spot in the stream that offers concealment on both bank. Observe the far side carefully. Embrace near and far side security for early warning. Clear the far side and then cross rapidly by quickly. Yung mga streams natin, yung hindi, yung tahimik na streams. Wire obstacles. Oh, mayroon man mga wire kung minsan. Kaya nga kung nagkakandak kami ng training dito sa field, dito sa parade ground ng Central Philippine University, naglalagay ako dyan ng wire obstacles. Meron kaming ginagawa para nagko-cross yung mga cadets, nakikita ng mga ibang cadets naman how to cross a barbed wire during daytime at saka night time. Avoid wire obstacle. Kaya wala, paano? Halimbawa, wala na kayo madaanan talaga. May wire. Hindi dyan kayo dadaan. Pero may techniques dyan. How to pass a barbed wire during daytime and not night time. Avoid wire obstacle. The enemy may cover obstacle with observation and fire. Next. Crossing of danger areas. When the platoon crosses a danger area independently, or as the lead element of a larger force, it must be 1, letter A, designate near and far side rally point. Ano yung rally point? Rallying point to, rallying point yan. Meaning to say, in case makompromise, meron kayong pupunta na safety area. Secure the near side. Right, left flank, and rear security. Rear security is the most important. Sinabi ko na sa inyo yung papasukin kayo kasi dyan kayo titirahin sa likod. Reconnoiter and secure the far side. Meaning to say, conduct first reconnaissance. The area. What is reconnaissance? Reconnaissance, a patrol. Reconnaissance is a patrol sent out to gather information first. Para kung secure yung area or not. Then they execute crossing the danger area by, number one, the platoon or squad leader decide how the unit will cross based on available time, the size of the unit, the size of the danger area. Ano yung size ng unit, saka size yung danger area. The field of fire into the area and the amount of security he can deploy. Butang na kung danger area, medyo alert tayo at saka hindi tayo dadaan dyan. Ganun ang ginagawa ko when I was in Mindanao. A small unit may cross all once by body. Meaning to say, by body yan. Dalawa-dalawa. Or one soldier at a time. A large unit normally crosses its element one at a time. As its element crosses, it moves to an overwatch position or to the far side rally point until told to continue movement. Number two, to maintain momentum, trailing platoons normally cross the danger area without conducting their own reconnaissance or establishing far side security. The lead platoon conducts reconnaissance and maintains far side security for the whole force. Bakit nagkakandak muna ng reconnaissance? You know why? That most important yan. Mag-send ka ng patrol to conduct intelligence information in the area. Alamin mo sa paligid before dadaan ang troops or else. Daan kayo na, lakad kayo ng lakad. Yung pala, yung kalaban, nag-establish na ng ambush position. So, very dangerous. Especially, ang dami ninyo. This is a large unit. Kaya, very careful. You conduct first a reconnaissance or clear the area before passing a place para at least hindi malagay sa peligro ang platoon or company. Crossing of a linear danger areas. Platoon ito, ah, this is a platoon. Ah. Platoon crosses the danger area in the formation and location as specified by the platoon leader. On the far side of the danger area, platoon continues the mission. Hmm. Meron ako ito dito na naglalakad ng platoon na hindi ko gusto. You know why? Mantakin mo itong kuwan na ito. Ha? Eh, may papakita ako sa inyo dito na naglalakad. Doon sila na nagtumpok-tumpok sila general or relief general yun. Eh. Ito, tignan ninyo natin. Yan o. Ito. Look at this. Actually ito, General Orhelio. Hmm? Oh. Sa isang kuan, kung makita ninyo yan, cadets, oh. Actual to, sa Cotabato ito. Oh. Dun sa, papunta sila dun sa kuan to. Oh. With the leading General Orhelio, pinaka-danger area yan. Oh. Kung makikita ninyo, actual to, pinicturan ko nga dahil matay, delikado to. Bakit? Kung andi dyan yung kalaban, paano ay di ubos sila doon sa ilog? Oh. Oh, okay. Makikita ba yan? Makita nyo ba, cadets? Yan. Alam mo, mahilig kasi ako yung actual na nagle-lecture ako with my experience ba? Mali ito eh, sa akin. Ako, meron akong comment dito. This is strong. Doon sila mismo. This is wrong, cadets. A troops walking or doon sila crossing a river wherein a platoon, more than platoon pa ngayon. Eh. Oh. Crossing a linear danger areas as platoon. The platoon crosses the danger area in the formation and location specified by the platoon leader. On the far side of the danger area, platoon continues the mission. You know, may mission kayo hanggat hindi nyo nakukuha. You proceed to your mission. As a soldier, once you are given an order, you cannot say no. But as long as the order are lawful, yes sir, proceed to the area, continue your mission. Mayroong casualty or not, proceed. Pag sabi niya, yes sir. Letter A, when the lead team signals, danger area relate throughout the platoon. The platoon halt. Halt. Oh, pass the word. I-pass the word na nga. May danger area tayo. The platoon leader moves forward, confirm the danger area, and determines what techniques the platoon will use to cross. The platoon sergeant also move forward to the platoon leader. Meaning to say, halt muna. The platoon leader will analyze the situation. Then if case delikado, mag analyze ngayon yung platoon leader kung saan siya dadaan para hindi mapiligro ang buong platoon. Yan. Just like me, bakit ako dadaan sa danger area kung delikado, mamamatay yung tropa ko. So analyzing ko yung situation bago ako dadaan sa danger area. I'm talking with experience. I've been in Mindanao, for Lanao, Kota, kaya meron akong kanta noon eh. Ha? Lanao, Cotabato, hanggang sa may Sambanga, Basilan at Hulo. Nadaanan ko lahat, ha? Yung pinaka-critical na lugar sa Mindanao. That's why, bakit ko padadaanin yung tropa ko doon? Nga delikado yung area. Di ba? Ganon yun. Just like the platoon leader. Analyze the situation, then go. Kaya ako magle-lecture, dapat ang mag-lecture dito yung experience para hindi mapiligro yung mga tao. The platoon leader informs all squad leaders of the situation and then designate the near side and far side of the rally point. Yung safe. The platoon sergeant direct positioning of the near side security usually conducted the trail squad. These two security teams may follow him forward when the platoon halts and danger area signals is passed back. Kaya palaging may security. As I've said, kailangan maging security conscious kayo palagi, not only the army but you. pag umuwi ka doon sa inyo, security palagi ang iniisip mo para pagdating sa bahay nyo, safe ka. The platoon leader reconnoiters the danger area and select the crossing point that provide the best cover and concealment. Number letter A, kailangan halt. Then after that, mag-send ka na isang squad, conduct reconnaissance kung safe ba yung danger area na yan or not. Gather info. Then, while conducting a patrol in that area, gathering information, cover and concealment. Ano yung cover? Cover is the protection from enemy fire while conducting reconnaissance. And concealment, protection from enemy observation while conducting reconnaissance. Yan ang tinatawag natin para safe ang platoon. Near side, letter F. Near side security observes the flank and overwatches the crossing troops. Security observes the flank. Kailangan ma-secure dyan bago dadaan na naman yung isang para safe lahat yung platoon. When the near side security is in place, the platoon leader directs the far side security team to cross the danger area. SOP na yan. Kailangan, dito ka. Ganito, para at least while crossing, secured yung platoon. H, the far side security team clears the far side. Pag sinabi clear, go. The far side security team leader establishes an OP forward of the cleared area. Ano yung OP? Observation post operation. As I've said, there are requirements observation of post. Seldom. Yun, ang tinetake note niya. Seldom meaning to say strength of the enemy, equipment of the enemy, location of the enemy, disposition of the enemy, organization of the enemy, and the morale of the enemy. Yun ang requirements sa observation post-operation, OP operation. Okay? The far side security team signals to the squad leader that the area is clear. Far side. Kaya security team signals to the squad leader that the area is clear. The squad leader relays to the message to the platoon leader, sir, pass the word, clear, pass the word. Give the order, give the instruction to the, ipass mo doon sa platoon leader that the area is cleared. Kailang malaman ng platoon leader na the area is clear. The platoon leader select the method the platoon will use to cross the danger area. Magsiselect siya. Dito tayo dadaan. Pag sabi ng platoon leader, kasi mahirap. Responsible for whatever the platoon does or fails to do. Ang platoon leader, responsible ka. The platoon quickly and quietly crosses the danger area. Yan. Quickly. Quietly. Next. Once across the danger area, the main body begins moving slowly on the required azimuth or direction. Ano yung azimuth? Kung sa map reading pa, yung forward azimuth mo. Kung sa map reading, required azimuth, forward azimuth sa 90 degrees or direction. Yung direction ng yung tinasawag ng azimuth, yung direction na pupuntahan ninyo. Sa kumpas na yan. Diba? There are, in one circle, there are 120 degrees. Four quadrants in one circle. Forward azimuth is 90 degrees para sa direction natin, safe. Letter N, the near side security element. Near side, controlled by the platoon sergeant. Yung platoon sergeant, may platoon leader, may platoon sergeant din. Yan ang nagkukumat. Pag sabi ng platoon na leader na, platoon sergeant, bigyan mo nga ng instruction yung squad leader na ganito. Yes, sir. Sabi niya, process the danger area where the platoon cross. They may attempt to cover any tracks left by the platoon. Siyempre, yung tracks left by the team. Sinong may responsible yan? Yung tail scout. Tail scout is responsible for the tracks left by the platoon or the last squad. The platoon sergeant ensure everyone crosses and send up the report. Then last, the platoon leader ensures accountability and resumes movement at normal speed. Normal speed na yon. Kung nakadaan na kayo sa danger area. Okay. Illustration. Sige, next. Crossing of a large open areas. Naku, yan ang pinakadelikado. Action at dangerous areas. Na, mga kuwan natin sa crossing large areas. Ito. Crossing and danger areas sa large. Large pa tayo, di ba? Okay. This an area so large that the platoon cannot bypass due to lack of time to accomplish the mission. Large eh. A combination of traveling over what's inbounding technique is used to save time. At any point in the open area where contact may be expected at once, the squad or platoon comes within range or small arms fire of the fire side about 250 meters. Yan ang estimate. The squad or platoon moves using the bounding overwatch. Ganun pa rin. Ha? Bounding overwatch, ha? By bounds. Technique. Once beyond the open area, the squad platoon reforms to continue the mission. So, by bounds pa rin ang pagmagkakuan para at least secured ang platoon. Crossing of small open areas. Yung open areas. This is an open area small enough to so that may be bypass in time allowed for the mission. Two techniques can be used. Mag-detour ka. Bypass method. Yung detour. Ibang daan dadaanan mo. By use of 90 degree. Turns to the right or left. The squad or platoon moves around the open area until the far side is reached. Then continues the mission. The distance of the offset and return leg shall be same, maintain the right movement direction. Shortcut ka na. B, countering, contouring around the open area. The leader designate the rally point on the far side with the movement azimuth. Sa direction yun, ha? Yung azimuth. When we mention about azimuth, sa map reading yan, sa direction na pupuntahan mo, decides which side of the open area to contour around. Yung contour na tinatabi yung mga lines, ha? Yung daanan, yung contour lines ng kung map, kung sa mapa pa. After considering the distance, terrain cover and concealment. Na, huwag niyo pa rin kalilimutan yung terrain, ha? Cover and concealment. I've been talking about cover and concealment kanina and moves around the open area. He uses the wood line and vegetation for cover and concealment. Yung vegetation, marami mang plant dyan, doon kayo mag-cover. Concealment, protection, doon kayo mag-conceal. When the squad or platoon arrives at the rally point on the far side, the leader resume the azimuth, go to the direction to the objective area and continues the mission. Okay. Crossing small open areas, ganito. Walang pahinga, basta army. Hanggang na until such time ma-accomplish mo ang mission mo. Na, next. Enemy contact at dangerous area. If the platoon makes enemy contact in the around the danger area for contact on a far side. Enemy contact. Ayan, enemy contact. Anong dapat gagawin? Of course, depende yung platoon leader, ha? Makes enemy contact in around the danger area for contact on far side. Depende na yun. Sabi niya, the reconnaissance element makes contact, flank security fires on enemy. Main body takes overwatch. The main body of the platoon position and fires on enemy. Security and recon return to main body. Smoke and indirect fires used to break contact. The platoon moves different places to cross the enemy. May guide dito. Ito yung pinaka-guide. But this one, I never experienced this. No? Hindi ko na-experience ito. Kami, puros element of surprise. Alam niyo yung element of surprise? Kasi ranger ako. Pero ito, infantry ito. Na, hindi ko na-experience ito. Pero na-experience din namin yung company operation, platoon operation. Wherein heavy casualty ang experience ko. Okay? Next. Oh, Enemy contact and danger. If the platoon makes enemy contact and all around the danger area or near side. Oh, flank security teams fire in the direction of the enemy. Yan ang requirements, number one. Number two, the platoon moves quickly across danger area. Oh, dito naman sa enemy, the platoon set up overwatch position. Security team cross danger area and rejoin squad. Smoke or... ang gagawin nyo, use. The platoon moves out of the area. Umalis ka agad sa killing. Security during movement. Platoon and squads enhance security during movement. Oh. Security, ha? During movement. Importante yun. Sinasabi ko, palaging security. Letter A, using the proper movement formation and technique. Na-discuss na natin kanina yung mga different formation para ma-secure ang mga bawat isa. And meron tinatawag nito na sector of fires. Sector of fires always sa... needed in this movement, moving as fast the situation will allow. This may degrade the enemy's ability to detect the platoon or squad and the effectiveness of his fires once detected. Pag na-detected, wala na. Moving along terrain that offers cover and concealment. Yung terrain na pwede kayo mag-cover and mag-conceal. Enforcing noise and light discipline. The same kanina, kailangan may combat discipline. Using proper camouflage technique. Nakita nyo yung ROTC kanina, nag-camouflage sila. Yung using proper camouflage technique, nakita nyo kanina yung Central Philippine University Rifle Squad. Ganon ang gagawin, mag-camouflage. Next. By the way, meron akong ginawa ito. This is, ito yung ginagawa sa tactical inspection. Pero actual ito, ha? The sequence of command. This is a rifle squad. Requirements ng tactical inspection ito. Kaya palagi kami nagna-number one. Look at this guide. Itong rifle squad. This is a from file formation, ha? Meeting engagement, fire, enemy, ando doon. Then the team leader, the point man will shout contact front. Nandito, squad leader will repeat the command contact front. The squad leader will command squad line formation move. Nag squad line na sila dito. Alpha Bravo team. Ito na, yung squad leader will command ceasefire. Squad leader will command prepare for assault. Squad leader will command grenadier, throw a grenade. Squad leader will throw a grenade. Assault. Squad leader will search. After this search, the squad leader will command, consolidate and reorganize. 5 o'clock. Tatakbo yan sila. Checking of men. Squad leader will command, count off all around security. Ito yung procedure ng meeting engagement. Next. Ito. Ambush, counter ambush. Ito yung sequence. I will just leave this to you. Basahin nyo yung sequence of command. Ito actual na ginagawa dito sa CPU to. Sa field natin. Cadets. Anyway, maiwan man dito ito, di ba? You study this. Very self-explanatory. Ambush, counter, ambush. Sa akin lang ito yung nilalagay. Ito yung rifle squad to. Next. Ambush, counter, ambush. Japon eh. Ha? Ambush right. Andito yung sequence of command. Basahin nyo yung sequence of command. Next. Hasty ambush. Yung iyan, tinatawag na chance ambush. Ang nag-ambush nito, yung kwa natin, yung rifle squad ang nag-ambush. Hasty yan, chance ambush. Nag-establish ng ambush position. In-ambush nila yung kalaban. Ito yung ngayon yung mga different position. Dito yung sequence of command. Next. Yan. Your army at your service across the land. And next. Well, cadets, thank you very much for your time. I hope meron kayong nakuha sa akin. As I've said, pag nagle-lecture ako, ini-insert ko yung experience ko. Sineshare ko sa inyo. wherein na meron kayo talagang totoo na nangyayari na makukuha ninyo based on the book at saka experience ang na-lecture ko sa inyo. So I hope meron kayong napulot na maganda para kung mag-aarmy kayo. Si Sir, pag nagle-lecture pala ito, libro at saka sineshare niya yung experience niya. Well, it's really very, mas maganda yung sineshare mo para at least. Kung books tayo ng books, hindi ba pala ito ang tunay? Meron din pala hindi nangyayari doon na actual ang ginaganap natin doon sa actual battlefield. So again, I will just leave this. You read those notes and references. This is our last lecture, cadets. And I hope to see you again sa second semester na walang sakit, hindi kayo nakaranas ng COVID, na magkikita-kita muli tayo sa second semester. Again, thank you for your time today and thank you for listening. Advance Merry Christmas to all of you. Thank you very much.